what to see, what to rent, and what to skip. It's Movie Reviews with Ryan J.
Hello! That's Ryan's new open. It's fantastic. And it is time for Ryan J. Reviews. He's the nationally syndicated film critic. You like it?
I love it. I have to thank Dan Code, your technical producer, for
his amazing
genius and hard work he put into that. So thank you, Dan Code, wherever he is.
Yeah, he wasn't here before. He's not anymore. But I love that, like, see it, rent it, or skip it.
It's kind of my rating system.
And who's the guy who voiced that?
He's a very talented, very well-known in Hollywood voiceover artist. His actual name is Harry Legg. Google him.
No way.
Two G's. Yeah.
Harry Legg.
He's brilliant. He's a brilliant. He voices like TV commercials, and he does movie trailers, and he's a bigwig in the voiceover.
Did you get him to do that?
I did.
That's awesome.
No, yes. Thank you.
That's super cool. I love that.
I hope he has a kid named him Shaved Leg.
He has a sister named Margaret Peg.
Okay.
Seriously. Okay. So
I like that.
Peg Leg.
Yeah.
His
parents were cruel.
Well, I knew so many people. Like I knew a family. Their last name was Book, so they named their daughter Story. Like storybook, and then isn't that horrible? And another person
I have friends who named their kids Northwest. Thank you for laughing.
That was funny.
Those of you who love entertainment know that it's Kanye and Kim Kardashian.
Oh, I love that. That's
not my
awesome.
Friends, thank goodness.
All right, should we talk about movies? Should we talk about Getaway?
Stop giving more names. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
This is one of the worst movies of the year.
No way.
It's terrible. Love it when you say that.
I can't help it. This is the kind of movie where you feel like Nicolas Cage passed on the script for this film. It's that bad. It stars Selena Gomez and Ethan Hawke, and they're basically spending an hour and 25 minutes in a car being chased by cops, and there's just car crashes behind them. It's the most monotonous, boring thing. I'm actually offended by this movie because I feel like the entire thing looks like it was shot on a cell phone.
No way.
No way.
Yes.
How about the cast? I mean, you do have Ethan Hawke there.
You know, normally I like him, and Selena Gomez is someone who I think is very pretty, and I think she has some great music, but she really hasn't proven herself yet as an actress. She doesn't have chemistry with Ethan Hawke. They don't play lovers, but they just are very awkward in this scene together, their scenes together. John Voight plays the bad guy, but literally for an hour and 25 minutes, you do not see him. There's just close-ups of his lips, and
Weird.
He does this really awkward bad guy accent. You can't, it's not placeable.
Here's the thing about you saying that you're offended by it. Here's what offends me about movies like this, is if I paid to see it in a theater.
Well, that's why you have me here, is to
help
you avoid paying for a movie like this.
And so it's a skip it.
A big skip it. Yeah,
okay,
this movie is really, really bad.
Let's move on then.
Closed Circuit.
Closed Circuit. This is a thriller, a British political thriller that's about a high-profile case of terrorism in London. It stars Eric Bana and Rebecca Hall, and it's sort of tepid. It's kind of interesting. They have some good chemistry, but it's not really the most suspenseful movie.
It's very dark.
It is dark.
I mean, just in the color of the cinematography, very blue tone.
Right. It is kind of a dark movie. It's rated R, but just for like dramatic scenes, a little bit of violence. But
what about the cast?
The cast is okay. I really like Eric Bana and Rebecca Hall, and she has some really fantastic moments. She's best known for previously being in Vicky Cristina Barcelona, the Woody Allen movie that won Penelope Cruz an Oscar. It's worth seeing.
Okay.
She's in that, and she's great in this movie. Has some really good moments, but it's not the kind of movie that's going to give her an Oscar nomination just because it's not that great of a film.
Okay.
But they play exes who are trying to not work together but are reluctantly forced to work together. So there's some great kind of cat and mouse there. But overall, it's just a little bit slow and not enough courtroom drama to really warrant getting out to see. If you want to or you're interested in it, I just recommend renting this film.
Rent it. Okay, rent it. The Grandmaster, this is PG-13. I haven't heard of this one either.
Yeah, it's, the end of August is sort of the dumping ground for movie studios because it's after blockbuster summer season and we're about to get into Oscar season, so these random movies are coming out now. The Grandmaster is a biopic of Ip Man. There have been several based on this man. He is known as being the master who taught Bruce Lee. And I like some martial arts movies, but this one is a little slow and boring, and the story is just kind of straightforward. And there's something very awkward and weird in the editing and the shots of this film. There's several, well, this scene looks like Anne Marie Smooth Criminal Michael Jackson video.
It looks like right?
I just kept thinking while I was watching the scene in the movie, Annie, are you okay?
Totally.
Yeah. Okay. Anyway, but so this was the opening
of
the film.
It's
very weird. They do this weird strobing effect on several shots that I thought was a mistake in the movie, but it's repeated a consistently through the film, and so I didn't like that.
Looked like a video game.
Yeah, it's...
No, go ahead.
There are some really good martial arts movies out there, like for The Forbidden Kingdom or The House
Karate
of Flying...
Kid.
Yeah, exactly.
Dragon.
You know, that are worth seeing, that I'd say rent those and skip this one instead.
So okay. All of them were skipping. Were you just in a bad mood when you went to all these
movies? No, it's just a bad week. This is the weekend to, like, stay home and do your laundry. Or there is another movie in theaters.
Stay home and do your
laundry. One Direction, the concert film, One Direction, This Is Us. That's a new opening today. And so, you know, I didn't see that one because last week I skipped the screening to go talk to Joseph Gordon-Levitt. But... You know who you are. You know who, if you're a fan of this group, yeah. And you like music documentaries and that sort of thing.
And so. People can go for free.
Yes. Well, first of all, I'm also giving away a new fragrance, the new One Direction fragrance.
That's
you can get a
hilarious.
Shot of this very quickly. The band
it's
came
called
out with,
You Don't Know You're Beautiful.
It's called Our Moment.
Oh.
It's their first fragrance. And what I actually like about when some celebrities, not all of them, but when they collaborate on a fragrance, these guys actually worked with the scientists and picking out, you know, the top notes and the low
well,
notes and that
out.
Kind of
Let's
stuff.
Smell
and so
it.
I don't know if I want to open it because it's new, so
oh,
I haven't
it's a
been
gift?
Able to. Yes,
oh.
I'm giving this
oh,
away
I,
to one
might be collectible.
Winner. You go to my Facebook page to enter, but there that's also where you're going to go to enter to win. The free tickets. Now, this new concert movie, One Direction, This Is Us, I'm giving away 10 Admit 2 passes, good at any Marcus Theater, any Monday through Thursday, starting September 2nd, and you can enter to win at my Facebook page, facebook.com/RyanJReviews.
Love that.
Cool.
Fun.
I guess we can't use the perfume because, like you said, you're giving away.
That you don't
sense.
Know you smell beautiful.
Okay, so here is where nice. You need to go to get the full reviews because we had two skip it, one rent it. People can go to RyanJReviews.com. Right there. Oh, your shirt's kind of
awesome.
Keying out.
Ooh.
I like it.
Well,
it's like you're
it.
Bedazzling. Ooh, there. Yeah, I like that.
My
way
Wonder Woman pose.
Mm-hmm. Nice
Thanks,
having.
Ryan. Great
Thanks,
to
guys.
Have you.